We have to think like a hack. If the humidification system for the pool room was located behind that filter grill, behind sound deadening foam, and behind two filters that were wedged in there, you have to think like a hack. Where would you put the radiant manifold? If that's where the thermostat is, the control for the humidification system.
It's gotta be in this vicinity.
You would think.
That's true.
But look at the thing, that's nice. See, laggy, see that?
Mm-hmm.
Listen, for $600 on Amazon, there's a link in the description box down below. What do you expect? It's not a FLIR i7. You know, $3,000 machine, it's $600. Come on, it works. It's nice. It works so much that I gave Daniel my FLIR i7. It's in his tool bag, and I took the cheap one that I got for free. By the way, 10 people bought these so far since I got this.
Get a nice cut off that, huh?
Well, I get 6%.
Not bad.
Yeah, not bad. Amazon commission affiliate? Yeah, not bad. Okay, let's see if we can see anything related to radiant for pool room back in the command center. Or said pipes palace, do not touch.
First floor.
Okay, master family studio, that's hopefully not, those aren't the real runs. Gym, main quarter, guest bedroom. That's kind of like where we just were. Main entrance, second floor. Kitchen, living room, dining room, laundry room. Guest bathroom. I don't see anything that shows pool. Maybe they don't have anything for a pool.
Right there, swimming pool.
Oh.
There's four.
Four.
And there's that manifold right there. That's circulator.
Swimming pool. Wow, look at this. Damn, you're good.
Damn.
It says swimming pool. All right, so this is showing 125. This is showing like maybe 90, right? Keep in mind, these are showing 90 as well. They're all showing 90, but this is showing 125. This is kind of like hot, right? It gets cool here, but that's cold. That's colder. That's very colder. And that's like room temperature. If we look at our HIK micro, if I put my hand there, is that right there? Let's see, watch. Let's see if my hand will increase the temperature of the pipe hotter than it is now, right now. Yeah, almost, barely, just barely. So we have a dead circ. Could be airbound.
I don't know, because look, you got hot on two of them, but then.
But what's the temperature showing though? Because this is not really, this is nowhere near gonna heat anything.
97?
Yeah.
97.
All right, let's take a look at pressure of the system. 15, maybe 12 PSI right there. We could try purging. However, this is our supply. This is the return. Why did they add these though? I don't know why they did that. Oh, this is, holy shit. Wow, you know what all these are for?
What?
Take a wild guess. Let's follow the pipe. I like when, as I'm showing like new homeowners, or if I'm there, the first guy instructing anything. So all these are closed. Right? And all these are coming from off the return right here, right? And they all go with T's. Follow it.
Oh.
Wow.
Wow.
Yo, I say this often, but this is tits.
That, yeah.
Wow. They're built-in drain stations, purge stations for every single one. So if I wanted to purge, let's say this one, for example, I close this, open up this. So let's do that right now. You ready?
Yeah, let's do it.
Let's check our pressure. Our pressure is around 12 PSI. There's our Tego half-inch pressure-reducing valve. Let's add some pressure to the system. Looks like we're almost at 20. Let's give it some more. Hear that tank making some noise though, right? Yeah.
It's supposed to do that.
It's getting some pressure. Here's our relief valve. Did we check that? Yeah, that's a 30 PSI. Good, excellent. That was on the previous video. Or maybe I'll incorporate them both together. But I think that this should make its own video.
Yeah.
Because I need content for weekends, holidays, when I go on vacation. Okay. So there's swimming pool. There's this one. So I want you to take that imaging camera. We're going to see which one heats up when I open this.
I'd probably say that.
The first one?
Yeah.
It makes sense. And the guy who put this in obviously had a lot of... He must have had an unlimited budget, by the way. To do what he did here...
I mean, they cut it short, though, because they ran PEX. They should have just did copper.
Well, you know? But look how they did the PEX.
That's true.
You know? All right. Let's... Actually, this is Charleston, North Carolina. Oh, South Carolina. Yeah.
Okay.
We're going to see if...
And pressure.
It's in the manual position.
Pressure-reducing valve.
Let's see. I'm going to open up this. Let's make sure they're all closed. I don't know.
Yeah, it's definitely getting hotter.
Is that one?
Yeah.
Alright.
115, 116.
I'm going to open up, hold this open as well at the same time. The manual fill on the Taco. So that's heating up. Good. That's definitely getting hot. Perfect. Yeah. We're checking our pressure. We're getting those to 25 PSI. Okay. Definitely the first one. It's four. Making note of our pressure. Now we're at 20. And as that hovers down, I'm adding more by opening up the Taco half-inch pressure-reducing valve up here. Force-feeding, this is what you wanted to see. Force-feeding more water while I'm purging that zone. At the same time, making sure my pressure doesn't exceed 30 PSI. So I'm doing both. And what I like to hear is air coming out of here. First four, but I don't think we're gonna get that. We're almost at 30. Close that back. I think if there was any air in the line, we've gotten it out already. To get any air that's right here out of the system, just like that. Do that once or twice. Closed, closed, open. Okay? Now, it's going to be really early to tell, but if we take our thermal imaging camera to the floor in the pool room, soon, if it's circulating, we should be able to see circulation down there. However, are these on? I have a good gut feeling that our radiant, this one's on. Here's a very good example. So look at the camera, the thermal camera.
Hello?
No, no, no. Town of Hempstead. I live in the town of Hempstead and the roads are shitty on my block and the curbs are horrible. I actually replaced my own curbs. Spent like $10,000 to replace the curbs and some sidewalks. All right, but I got this new car, and I don't want to F up the car. So I've been writing letters. First, start with the highway department, commissioner of the highway department. Then they referred it to the commissioner of engineering, right? Who CC'd the town commission, the town supervisor. So every week I send them a letter, like when, when. And so she called like, "Wait, I don't have a time yet." I was like, "Well, I'm going to keep writing you letters every week until I do get a time." That's what I'm going to do. But she said, "Okay, no problem." That's exactly what I'm going to do. All right. So if you notice that this zone valve has no resistance in the lever underneath, which means it's on. The dining room has resistance, so it's off. But I wanted to show, like, I can keep my hand on this circulator right here. I can. And I'm going to take that hand, well, different hand, and try to touch this one. It is significantly hotter.
Yeah, that's like 160 degrees.
Yeah, this circulator is burning up. And if you feel this, this is starting to cool off than what it was before. And is it moving water? Probably not. But, not that we're gonna be able to see anything downstairs, but let's go downstairs and see if we see anything.
On the heat on the, you know, the living room area.
Why?
So I'm gonna see like it's not too much heated.
Okay.
Yeah, because okay. When I'm gonna turn on, you know, like keep it like.
I'm not staying here all day.
I know.
Okay.
So I'm gonna check, you know, like.
Okay.
After you like, when I just turn on this heat, like keep it 70. That's
well, it's 78 now in the room, so you're not gonna be. How are you gonna turn it on? But is it raising it to 80?
Oh. Nighttime, I'm gonna try.
Okay, but I'm getting paid today.
Yeah.
Just so you know. Okay. I'm not waiting like I did last week, like a moron.
No, because. Like a
70, then it's gonna be burning hot. That's what I'm saying. Okay. You gotta
check, like everything is fine.
Okay.
So, yeah.
Okay. Alright. Keeping it real. Alright. I don't think you're gonna see anything with the camera, but. Oh, I had all that going too, by the way. Let's see if we see anything with this camera. Nah. We're definitely not gonna see anything yet. No, it's a hose. Is it working? It doesn't come on instantly like that.
Like when I'm telling it to heat it up over there, I don't want right now it's yeah. 61 floors. I'm not sure it's working over there.
You just lowered it.
No, it's increases. It was 72, I just make it 76.
Okay, yes. It was on, yes.
Yeah,
it's reading 61 in here, yes.
It's only 60.
It's not working.
You know.
It's not working. Correct.
Yes. Hello?
So here it's working.
That's one of the reasons why we offer a maintenance plan is because on systems like this you have to check it out every so often. Usually once a year. This boiler, you know, it's a detailed manual to service it every year. How old's the house?
Like they just started moving like
they moved. No. How old's the house?
Two years old.
All right, I think we're good. Okay, so now we were working on 1, 2, 3, 4. All right, each one has our own temperature gauge on it. So this one looks like it's 90. This one looks like it's maybe almost 80. That was closer under 75-ish. This was closer to like 75-ish. But we're going to see now if we have circulation on these. And these temperatures go up. All right, this one's still cold, circulating there. If you look down here, that's our leaving temperature is 155. And these don't feel like 155. This one feels hot. And so does this one. These are the last two. These are the two we just did, but we just gotta wait, give it some time, and we need some little bit of patience here, all right? It's not gonna happen.
So I gave them the estimate to replace that Teco circulator. I factored in the aggravation factor, which means possibly waiting a week to get paid and, you know, going back and forth and texts and emails, but it's no bueno. But, need a new circulator. We're not getting circulation there, and that will solve. No heat, no reading heat in the pool room. All right. Couple announcements. Number one, I got a few of these left. Let me see if I can show you. Hold on. Let me put you right there. Right. Nope. Let's see. I'll put you right here. See these shirts? This is the original Pipe Doctor shirt. I got nothing on the back. This is a medium. I got 1, 2, 3. I got 3 mediums. I got 1 large. Pipe Doctor Home Services, Let's Go Bosch. And let me show you.
I gotta show you this. You'll like this, guys. You really will. Let's go down to the garage.
All right. I got a bunch of these. All right. This is 2X, the Pipe Doctor, Mikey Pipes, the IDS logo. I got a whole bunch of those, see? I got a whole stack. It's time that I give back. And you know what, if you email me right now, mikeypipes.com, I'll throw it in the mail, send it off to you, and you'll get it before Christmas, Kwanzaa, maybe even Hanukkah. And just gonna throw it out there, HVAC paid for it.